Hi everyone, and welcome to part 3 of a video series that I'm doing of an ATV trip my friends and I did across Newfoundland, Canada in September of 2018. On this particular day, we started in Glenwood, and then we went directly south down to the St. Martins in the Woods plane crash site from 1946. Then we went cross country on the transmission line over to Grand Falls for some gas. And then we continued on from there on the rail bed, which is in blue, all the way over to Trailblazers in Badger. We spent the night there and then started again the next day. If you do a Google search for the Sabina plane crash site, you'll find lots of websites and videos telling you all about that incredible crash, what the survivors went through, and the incredible work that the rescuers had to go through to get out in the middle of nowhere to find these people and bring them back to civilization. Like I mentioned at the end of the previous video, we spent the night at Misty River Cottages in Glenwood. It's very convenient. It's right off the trail. From there, we walked over to the Moosehead Lounge, which was next door, had a great breakfast, went back to our rooms, packed up. Then we got on the trail, stopping immediately at Johnny's One Stop for some gas and some water and things like that. And then we got on the trail. So right after we get gas, we get on this mountain road here in the Orange Trail. Now it's a road, it's not the rail bed. You can do 60 or more kilometers an hour easily, so you can make quick work of this trail here. And this marking where it shows water on the trail is a river you have to cross. Actually, you don't have to. There's a bridge up the road you can take instead if you like, but we usually cross it on the way over and then take the bridge back. And this year, we couldn't believe how low the water was. They had an incredibly dry summer in Newfoundland this year, and a lot of places that we had been to, we couldn't believe how low the water was.
That's really low.
Please don't mind some of the hokey music that I use here and there. It's hard to find good free music on the internet. So after our pit stop at the riverbed, we got back on the dusty trail, and you can see in the video that it was pretty dusty. The rest of the way into the plane crash site from here is about 5 miles. It's not hard going. It's a little slow in some places just because bushes and alder brushes are growing up over the edges of the trail, but it's not really hard to get in there. And then you get to the very last part of the trail, which you can take your machine on, but it's really rough driving in, lots of rocks and things, so I suggest you don't bother and just leave it at the bottom where the P is here on my map, and then we walk in the rest of the way, which is about a half a mile. For those of you that watch these videos that are interested in doing this trip across Newfoundland yourself, make sure that if you do the entire island, if you go from east to west, that you stop in and see this site. It's really quite something to see in person. I mean, pictures really don't do this justice. It adds about 50 kilometers to your day if you're going from Gander to Badger, but it's totally worth it. And the roads that you take to get down to here and then leave and go towards Grand Falls, they're transmission line roads and they're in fantastic shape, as you'll see here shortly. So this is the transmission line we're on right now. You can see it's in great shape. You could drive a car on this road if you wanted to. And so you can go along at a good clip here and save yourself some time. And we stop a lot on our days, like we stop and talk a lot, and we still make Badger by evening before sunset, or usually right around sunset. So if you're worried about these extra kilometers that you're adding on this section of your trip, don't worry about it. Depending on how fast you travel and how many stops you can make it to Badger before sunset, no problem. The transmission line will take you all the way into Grand Falls. The only issue you have here is when you get to this section of road right there, it goes from dirt trail to paved roads. So you're actually driving through some subdivisions in town and so forth for about 3 kilometers. It's technically not legal to be driving ATVs in Newfoundland on the roads, but we haven't had any issues yet, luckily. And I mean, we don't drive like Yahoos or anything by any means. And, you know, we just drive about 40 kilometers an hour or so, which is about 25 miles an hour. And we try to stick together as a group. And we usually only go on the roads just to get to gas stations, different trailheads, things like that. It's not very often that we have to do it. We want to be respectful as we go through these towns. We don't want to wear out our welcome over there. We always slow down a lot when there's pedestrians around. We just don't like to kick up any rocks or dust on people that are walking on the trails. The distance to Trailblazers and Badger, where we're going, from where we stopped at the gas station, is about 30 kilometers. It's usually a little over an hour for us to do that, and there are some sections after the gas station that have a lot of whoops in the road, as you can see here in this section of the trail.
I've seen you bounce there pretty good.
Just before we got to Badger, maybe about, I don't know, 6 miles out or 10 miles out or so, one of the machines, one of the side-by-sides had a breakdown that we were not able to fix on the side of the road, so it needed to go to a dealership. I towed it back to Badger for the night, and then when we got there, I put a message out on my Crossing Newfoundland Facebook page to see if anyone was out there could give us an idea of how we could ship the machine to Cornerbrook, which was the town we were going to the next day. And I couldn't believe how many people started sending me messages asking to help, and we ended up getting this one gentleman that came with his pickup truck. He picked up Terrence's machine, drove it to Cornerbrook to the dealership for us, and all he wanted for his time was just his gas money. This is the type of thing that we've run into before, not with other breakdowns, but with just any other issues we've had sometimes in Newfoundland, and the people there are so gracious and so friendly. They will go out of their way to help you out any way they can. You know, we've been staying at Trailblazers for years, for several reasons. One being that it's so convenient, it's right off the trail. It has everything you need in there. It'll sleep 8 or more people. It has a full kitchen, a large gathering area, like a large family room, if you will. And it has a washer and dryer, so this is usually our third day on the trip. We throw our clothes in the washer and use them over again. It's very convenient for us to be able to pack less. And the owner treats us very well. He's very friendly. The rates are great. And also, they also own a home that they rent out too, a 3-bedroom home. So that if you have more than 8 people, like we do, we had 12 people this year. So 8 of us stayed at Trailblazers, and then the other 4 stayed at their house, which is just up the road a little bit. Thanks for watching, everyone. Stay tuned for part 4, where we go from Badger to Deer Lake. Lots of beautiful scenery on that day. We're going to be at the Gaff Topsail, which is a mountain peak. We're about 1,800 feet up, I think, at the summit. Get some great pictures from up there. And then we go around a lot of beach areas in the Howley area. You're not going to want to miss that one.